Millions in Syria and Iraq are facing water shortages as the region's longest river, the Euphrates, dries up.
From the depths of heaven, where light and darkness intertwine, a profound event unfolded. Hundreds of angels fell from grace and were sent down to the earth, only to be chained for eternity, chained near the Euphrates River. Recently, archaeologists released a video where they heard loud screams of beast-like entities from under the Euphrates River, and it terrified everyone who witnessed it. What is the nature of these mysterious, gut-wrenching sounds, and who are the four angels bound in chains? Why are they being held captive near the Euphrates River? The Euphrates River is considered to be Asia's longest river and runs through Syria, Iraq, and Turkey before joining the Persian Gulf. The Euphrates River has been drying rapidly according to some reliable sources, and it's been claimed that 80% of its total volume has been lost to severe droughts in the region since the 1950s. This phenomenon, which has caused panic around the globe, as some people associate the drying up of the Euphrates River with the biblical prophecy of the Euphrates. Why is Euphrates drying up so rapidly? According to the book of Revelation, the drying up of the Euphrates River is a sign of the end times. While many people regard the drying of the Euphrates with human activities and climate change, believers associate it with the fallen angels. The concept of fallen angels has intrigued theologians, scholars, and believers alike from time immemorial. However, there are stories in the Bible and other non-canonical texts about fallen angels that are hard not to believe. The Revelation is the final book of the Bible, written by the Apostle John on the island of Patmos, which has countless interpretations, yet all of them portray the utterly captivating apocalyptic event, the Armageddon. The Battle of the Armageddon will be the greatest battle that anyone has ever seen mentioned in the book of Revelation. It takes place in the last days when the Antichrist gathers kings in a place known as Armageddon. These kings will be loyal to the Antichrist and will gather their armies to wage war against the people of God. The people who side with the Antichrist will be destroyed by the four angels that have been kept captive under the Euphrates for thousands of years. Chapter 9, verses 14 through 16 says, "It said to the sixth angel who had the trumpet, release the four angels who were bound at the great river Euphrates. And the four angels who had been kept ready for this hour and day and a month and year were released to kill a third of mankind. I heard the size of their army, which was 200 million mounted troops." In the celestial realm, angels hold various roles and are ranked according to their hierarchy. Among them was Lucifer, the leader of the fallen angels. He had the highest position as a cherub, a beautiful one too, and one of the highest ranks among the angelic hierarchy. The book of Ezekiel chapter 28, 12-17 portrays him as adorned with precious stones, reflecting his splendor and beauty. He was God's favorite and his proximity to God, and his unique attributes set him apart from other angels. Other angels admired him, and he was the angel of angels. Lucifer, also known as the Morning Star, became so prideful that he started to desire for personal exaltation. He dreamt of being an equal to God and wanted to be admired by God's creation. His rebellious behavior and utmost disrespect to God led to his downfall. However, he was not the only one who was banished from heaven onto the earth. Many other angels, who were ardent followers of Lucifer, went with him. It's said in the Bible that one-third of the angels joined Satan's rebellion. The rebellion that took place in heaven led to a war between Michael, the archangel, and his angels versus Lucifer and his fallen angels. The result was evident. Lucifer had no place in the realm of angels. Some of the angels that followed Lucifer were bound in chains waiting for their judgment, And this had been mentioned in Jude 1:6. It's been said, and he has kept with eternal change in darkness for the judgment of the great day, angels who did not keep their own position but deserted their proper dwelling. Non-canonical books like the Book of Enoch have different versions of the story. The Book of Enoch introduces the concept of watchers, a group of angels who descended to earth who were led by the leader known as Azazel. The reason why they descended to the earth is different from the Bible. God had appointed the watchers to watch over human beings and their activities. However, they were not supposed to approach humans or interact with them. However, the watchers grew lustful towards the mortal women, who were extremely beautiful. The watchers decided to betray God and indulged in carnal sins with the women, who then bore their children, an abomination known as the Nephilim, who were giant creatures that could destroy everything that stood before them. The watchers were all captured by four archangels, Michael, Gabriel, Raphael, and Uriel, and their offspring, the Nephilim, were destroyed by the great flood that happened during the time of Noah. The watchers were then cast to the deeper depths of the desert and were chained until the end of times. The Bible does not clearly state why these angels were chained or bound under the Euphrates River, but you have to figure that it was something horrible. Not even Satan was held captive like these four angels, which means that these angels might be the worst out of all. However, the book does not mention Lucifer, but provides a broader understanding of the rebellion of the fallen angels against God. Lucifer and the Watchers were entirely different entities, according to some, as both of them rebelled against God for different reasons. While Lucifer, or the devil, is associated with evil, temptation, and opposition to God's will, the Watchers are the group of angels who interact with humanity in forbidden ways by teaching them witchcraft, wizardry, and many other forbidden technologies. However, many interpretations claim otherwise. It's said that Satan had instigated this whole plan of the Watchers, having carnal relations with women so that they could pollute the human seed in order to stop God's plan of sending a Messiah on earth. The Messiah, who was supposed to come on earth and destroy Satan. God couldn't stay idle and watch Satan succeed in his endeavors. In 2 Peter 2:4, it's been said, "For if God didn't spare the angels who sinned, but threw them down into Tartarus and delivered them to be kept in chains of darkness until judgment." The four angels of the Euphrates are definitely among the angels described in this verse. Therefore, people believe that these four angels are the ones who are making these noises and trying to break their chains so that they may be released and destroy one-third of humankind. Does this mean that the day of judgment is near? Why would these angels, who had stayed dormant for thousands of years, start to get disturbed? One-third of the angels chased out of heaven were not allowed to roam freely on earth, but were bound or chained until the appointed time, as these fallen angels did not have a peaceful demeanor. They're violent and would do anything to divert God's principles. As the number of videos that indicate these events are limited and could even be fabricated by people so as to mislead people, but this doesn't negate the fact that the chained beasts are real. In reality, if the chained beasts have started to attempt breaking their chains, something must be up. Whatever may be the reason, it's true that these four angels are kept in captivity as a form of punishment for their rebellion against God and their involvement in corrupting humanity. They're being restrained until a specific time or event designated by God known as the Great Tribulation. We as believers have a duty to look for signs from the book of Revelation so that we can prepare ourselves both physically and spiritually for what awaits us. The book of Revelation provides hope to us believers through its message of ultimate victory, divine justice, and the promise of a renewed and restored world. It provides us a message of hope and assurance for those who faithfully follow God. It also provides us hope through the promise of a new heaven and earth, where a new world will be created free from creation, sin, and death. A future where God will dwell with his people, just like he once did with Adam and Eve before they were banished from the Garden of Eden. The book of Revelation reminds us that no matter how challenging our present circumstances may be, we can always find hope and assurance in the promises of God. Therefore, we must be faithful and abide by his laws so that we may be saved on the day of judgment. What do you think will happen on the day of judgment? Will everything go exactly as said in the Bible? Will the trapped angels be released during the end times? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below.